It's AumSum time.
Why do people smoke?
Because they love coughing.
No.
Teens or young adults start smoking primarily because it feels glamorous and exciting.
Hooray!
Watching friends as well as movie actors influences them as well. Cigarettes contain tobacco, which contain a highly addictive chemical called nicotine. When taken in, nicotine enters the bloodstream and quickly travels to the brain, releasing feel-good chemicals and removing unpleasant feelings. This helps adult smokers to cope with stress and stay focused. Shortly after completing the cigarette, a smoker starts feeling irritated and anxious. He starts feeling a mild nicotine withdrawal. On smoking the next cigarette, nicotine reaches the brain in less than 10 seconds, instantly giving a pleasant feeling and sense of calmness. This makes it very difficult to stop as the person starts becoming emotionally and mentally dependent on nicotine. This leads to many people becoming chain smokers, needing multiple cigarettes a day. How are smartphones changing us?
Ha! No one can change the one and only AumSum!
Yeah, you show off. Bending and staring down at our phones for several hours increases the stress on our neck and spine, leading to neck and back pain. Experts refer to this condition as text neck, and it can eventually lead to serious consequences. Also, at night, when we stare at our smartphones, the light emitted from their screens makes our brain think it is still daytime. So, our brain does not produce the sleep hormone melatonin, causing us to stay awake for long hours and thus disturbing our circadian rhythm, which regulates our everyday bodily functions. This can lead to obesity, diabetes, cancer, etc. An interesting fact is that smartphone addiction has given rise to a new phobia called nomophobia, short for no mobile phone phobia. It is basically the fear or anxiety of being without our phone. What happens to our body after we die?
It becomes a star!
Not at all. Doctors declare a person dead when his heartbeat and respiration stops and his brain is dead. Once a person is dead, all the muscles in his body relax. The jaw falls open, eyelids lose their tension and relax, etc. This state is known as primary flaccidity. Also, the body begins to slowly lose heat and the body temperature begins to drop until it matches with the surrounding. This is known as a death chill. As the heart has stopped pumping, within minutes, the blood begins to settle in the lower parts of the body, making those parts of the skin appear bluish purple or purplish red. This is called livor mortis. Within 3 to 6 hours, the muscles start to contract. This is known as rigor mortis. It can last from 24 hours up to 84 hours, after which the muscles again begin to relax. This state is known as secondary flaccidity. Now, if the body is burnt, it gets converted to ashes. Otherwise, the body starts decomposing. Since the blood circulation and respiration has stopped, the body can neither receive oxygen nor remove toxic byproducts like carbon dioxide. Hence, these toxic byproducts produce an acidic environment inside the cells, causing their enzymes to eat their own cells from inside out. Moreover, we have different microorganisms in our gut, on our skin, etc., as there is no immune system anymore to control these microorganisms. They travel to different parts of the body and begin to break down the tissues and organs, releasing various gases. These gases attract insects like flies, maggots, etc., which also eat and break down the tissues. Eventually, a time comes when only the skeleton is left. However, over time, the skeleton also decomposes. Is sugar bad for you?
No, because whenever I eat sugar, I get sweet treats.
All right, now listen. If we consume a lot of sugar, then it can lead to serious health problems. For example, a hormone called leptin tells our brain when to stop eating. However, consuming excess fructose, which is a type of sugar, can cause leptin resistance, a condition in which our brain does not respond to leptin. Hence, we overeat, resulting in obesity. Moreover, excess sugar is converted into a type of fat called triglycerides. Triglycerides can enter the bloodstream and form fatty deposits or plaques in blood vessels, increasing the risk of heart attack, stroke, etc. Excess sugar can even bind to collagen and elastin in our skin, damaging them and thus making our skin saggy and wrinkly. Studies have also shown that women who have one or more sugary drinks per day are more likely to develop diabetes.